Hello everyone, a warm welcome to all the viewers. My name is Priya Singh Range and I'm an assistant professor at the LG Institute of Physiotherapy. The topic of the day is health promotion. Today we'll be looking at what is health, what is health promotion, the different strategies of health promotion, what are the principles, sites and approaches of health promotion. Now beginning with what is health. Health, as defined by the World Health Organization, is not merely the absence of disease, but a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being. WHO believes that the enjoyment of health is one of the most fundamental rights of a human being, regardless of their age, gender, race, religion, or economic background. And the health of the people is fundamental to achieve peace and security, and it requires cooperation from all the individuals and all the different states. Health promotion, on the other hand, is the process of enabling people to increase control over and to improve their health. Health promotion is more relevant today than before to the world, and especially in developing countries like India, because they face the triple burden of diseases, which includes the existing communicable diseases, the emerging and re-emerging communicable diseases, and a whole lot number of non-communicable diseases. All of these diseases, in one way or the other, are interlinked to lifestyles and behaviors. Hence, the most fundamental aspect of health promotion is lifestyle modification and behavior change. The different strategies that we can use for health promotion include building a healthy public policy. As discussed in the Global Health Conference, which was held in Shanghai in 2016, there are three pillars of health promotion: good governance, healthy cities, and health literacy. Strengthening governance and public policies to make healthy choices available and affordable to all and to create sustainable systems is one of the most fundamental strategies for health promotion. If the health policies that are built by the government are in accordance with the needs and demands of the people, which they require in order to maintain their health, the health promotion will not be needed at all, since all the basic requirements of each individual would be met. We need to create supportive environments. Only providing affordable and available resources is not sufficient. We need to create more supportive environments. An individual thrives in the environment that they live in. Hence, to be more healthy, it is essential that the environment surrounding an individual is clean, it is hygienic. Hence, we need to build an environment that can support the individual in maintaining their health. We need to strengthen the community action. It is not just one individual that is responsible for the promotion of health, it is the entire community. The responsibility of health promotion, or even the maintenance of health, does not rely on one individual alone. The entire community needs to be responsible for it. If only one particular individual maintains their health, then how is it helpful to the entire nation or the entire world? Hence, we need to strengthen the communities. We need to build community action so that whenever there is any calamity, any problem within a community, it gets sorted out within the community itself. We need to develop more personal skills. When we are focusing on personal skills, we need to think about each individual and their family. The individual needs to be responsible for themselves. The individual needs to be responsible for the community, but also for their family. The individual should be educated so that they can be made aware about what kind of choices they need to make, why they need to make those choices, which are the healthy choices for themselves and their families. If you're not educating the individual, they won't be able to know which are the healthy choices and which are the unhealthy choices. Hence, it is essential that we develop these personal skills so that the person, the individual, can have that decision-making power to decide for themselves and not rely on anyone else, the government or the community, to make these decisions for them. We need to reorient the health services towards health promotion. Most of the health services that we see nowadays focus more on the treatment or the management aspect of medicine. But we need to reorient these services towards promotion of health as well, towards prevention of different diseases, different pathologies, etc. If there is no pathology present, again, we can say that health is being promoted. Hence, we need to reorient the health services towards health promotion also, not just the management and the treatment aspect. The different principles of health promotion are that the health promotion needs to be population health focused. When we use any measures for promoting health, they cannot be focused on a single individual or a single community. They need to be focused on the entire population. Since health for any individual or any community is not sufficient, it needs to be social determinants focused. We have seen that different pathologies, different diseases, different conditions have different social risk factors. The purpose here for health promotion is that we need to eliminate those social risk factors or try to reduce those social risk factors. Hence, we need to focus on them in order to eliminate them. Health promotion needs to be able to combine a variety of methods. Now, health promotion can be done using different kind of measures. Like we can use individual approaches like face-to-face visits, home visits, etc. We can have mass approaches like using televisions, newspapers, radio, etc. So whatever different kind of approach we use, only using one approach is not sufficient. We need to use all these measures together. We need to use all the different kind of approaches together if we want to promote the health. Say if you are using only face-to-face or home visit approach of health promotion, what is going to happen with that? We'll be able to cover only a small number of population. This health promotion won't be able to be generalized to the greater population. Hence, we need to use mass approaches, we need to use group approaches, and we need to use individual approaches together to be more efficient for promoting health. We need to build collaborative partnerships. Using only one area or aspect of medicine is not sufficient. All the fields of medicine need to work collaboratively. We need to employ social workers, we need to employ nurses, we need to employ technicians, we need to employ doctors, physiotherapists, everyone. There needs to be a collaborative partnership among all the people of these different fields in order to promote health. The health promotion needs to be health workforce focused. It should be a principle of health promotion to develop a health workforce. Without development of a health workforce, it would be insufficient for the health promotion to reach a wider population. In order to reach a wider population, health promotion needs more staff, more number of people that are employed in order to do so. Hence, the main focus should lie on developing a good health workforce. The different sites where health promotion can occur are the community, the different healthcare facilities, the schools, and the work sites. So health promotion in a community is important because most of the people live in the community. When we are going to a particular community, we can spread the message to a larger number of people. A larger number of people can understand that and they can relate to it in a better way. And these people can go back to their families and can explain the benefits of health to them. When working in healthcare facilities, there is a chance for the doctor, the nurse, or any healthcare or medical personnel to get a direct contact or communication with the individual. Hence, we can explain the things better when there is a face-to-face contact with the individual. It can be done in schools. Since we all know that the schools have children, the future of any nation, the future of the entire world. If we are trying to promote health in schools, we are trying to develop health that can take us into the future. And when the children are taught about these health measures, they become more serious about it and they can use these methods again in order to spread the message to their family as well. Worksite health promotion is again important because, as we know, most of the accidents occur in work sites. We also know that there are several diseases like occupational diseases that occur at work sites. In order to reduce the prevalence of these occupational hazards, worksite health promotion needs to be done. The different approaches that can be used for health promotion, these are the conceptual approaches that you can see here in the video. according to the conceptual approach, we can divide the population, the entire population, in four different categories. We have the healthy population, we have the population that has some risk factors, we have the population that is showing the symptoms of any particular disease, and we have the population with known disorder, that is, they have been diagnosed with that particular disorder. We divide the entire population into these four different subgroups or categories, and we use different approaches for health promotion for each category. Like for healthy population, we need to promote a healthy lifestyle. We already know that the individual is healthy, but it is not certain that the individual may not have any pathology in future. Hence, it is very important that we explain to the individual what the importance of health is and what the importance of maintaining a good lifestyle is. And hence, promoting a healthy lifestyle is the first measure that we use in a healthy population. We need to prevent the risk factors, which is included in primordial prevention. We need to prevent certain disorders and health problems. In a population that already has risk factors, health promotion needs to be done. We need to explain the importance of maintenance of health, the benefits of maintaining health, and we need to screen the individuals that might actually be having the disease or pathology. We need to take action on these risk factors. We either need to reduce them or we need to eliminate them if possible. We need to ask the individuals to maintain a healthy lifestyle. In a population which already has the symptoms, early detection is important, since as early we are detecting the symptoms, we can treat the pathology with the same pace. Treatment and care will always follow early detection. When we are detecting any pathology early, we can change the pathophysiology of the particular disorder. We can change how the disorder is going to spread or increase in the future. We can ask the person to maintain a healthy lifestyle so the pathology is not worsened, and we can limit the disability, or we can focus on rehabilitation if we think that the pathology might not be completely cured or treated. In a population with known disorder, treatment and care is important. Since we already know the diagnosis, the patient has been diagnosed, we need to focus on the treatment and care. We need to focus on maintaining the healthy lifestyle, and again on disability limitation and rehabilitation. To summarize it all, health promotion is a diverse and growing field of public health. Health promotion is not a single-handed objective, but it requires cumulative efforts from the policymakers, the healthcare providers, the community, and the individuals themselves. A multi-sectoral program focusing on the community, the schools, the work sites, and the healthcare facilities should be the aim of health promotion. Here, thank you. I'm signing off.